Almost all of us had to deal with it at some point. Eye strain.
As you watch these light rays striking the magnified eye, similar tiny beams of light are entering your...
Especially in today's digitalized world, it has become much more widespread. In this video, I want to talk about the causes of eye strain, its effects, and how to treat and prevent it. And then later, I will share my own experiences and some tips. Let's talk about the causes first. One of the main reasons for developing eye strain is close-distance, focus-intensive work over long periods of time. Examples of activities like this would be reading, drawing, driving a car, or looking at digital screens. There are factors, however, that can worsen the strain on the eyes. Looking at blurry images is one of them. Our eyes then try to constantly focus on something that cannot be focused on, exhausting them even more. Double images caused by printing mishaps or faulty displays can also have this effect. Flickering from room lights or screens can be pain-inducing too, even the kind of flickering that we don't actively perceive. The iris of the eyes contracts every time the light is briefly turned on again. And then there are more underlying causes of eye strain. For example, refraction errors of the eyes, so near or farsightedness. Or your glasses or contact lenses have the wrong prescription. Muscle spasms can exhaust them faster, misalignment of the eyes, or drooping brows or lids, and various other eye diseases that cause blurred vision, light sensitivity, glare, or high amount of floaters. However, in this video I am mostly going to focus on external eye strain sources, like computer screens, drawing, or the like. If you have or suspect having a medical condition that causes eye strain, then getting the advice from a doctor will be far more helpful. Let's talk about the symptoms next. Pain in and around the eyes can be an indicator that your muscles are overexerted, especially the ciliary and extraocular muscles. Dry eyes are very common. When focusing, we just tend to blink less. Or sometimes the eyes get teary, the opposite therefore. Intermittent double vision can also be a symptom. Fatigue and dizziness, light sensitivity, blurred vision, problems concentrating, and also very common are headaches. I know that all of this can sound quite scary, but these symptoms normally aren't that serious or cause long-term issues. So I've been lied to as a kid. Looking at screens doesn't make your eyes rectangular. What an outrage! However, if you experience more serious symptoms like nausea or severe eye pain, then please consult a medical professional. So, what should you do in order to treat and even prevent eye strain? The most recommended method is very simple. Take regular breaks. A lot of experts say that a 20-20 approach would be good. After 20 minutes of eye straining work, close your eyes, or look at a simple non-moving object in the distance for 20 seconds or longer. I do understand that sometimes you forget to take breaks or just don't want to interrupt your workflow. But reminding yourself to take breaks will not only benefit your health, but your productivity too. Also, if you frequently overexert your eyes and don't take breaks, there is a small chance that the symptoms will occur more often. To counteract dry eyes, you can use eye drops. If you have a related medical condition or the wrong glasses or contact lenses, then resolving those issues with professional help will lead to relief for the eyes themselves. Sometimes the solution can be rather simple, like by using proper lighting. It's easier for the eyes to read a book in a brightly lit room than with just a dim desk lamp. Or looking on a computer screen is more exhausting in a dark environment. When reading, either on paper or a digital device, the font size and type plays an important role too. Since our computer, tablet, and smartphone screens are the main culprits nowadays, I want to especially focus on some advice to reduce the eye strain caused by those devices. After all, it is estimated that more than 50% of people struggle with it. Firstly, avoid using displays that use pulse width modulation, a technology that makes the screen turn off and on constantly, and that flickering gets worse on dimmer settings. Fortunately, nowadays most screens use DC modulation and are therefore flicker-free. And so one thing you can do to reduce the strain on your eyes is to lower the brightness of your devices. By how much depends on the screen though. You want to lower it so that the brightness isn't that jarring anymore, but not too much, otherwise the screen will lose too much contrast and tasks like reading will become more straining again. And speaking of contrast, one thing that is becoming more and more popular are dark modes or dark themes. It basically means that instead of having dark text and other elements on a bright background, it is the other way around. A lot of people say that it is much less exhausting to look at, and several studies have shown that there is a measurable difference in eye strain between light and dark mode, with dark mode being the overall winner. However, it is very subjective. There are also a lot of people who claim the opposite, that dark mode is actually more straining for them. There is a valid point to be made. A darker strain causes the pupils to dilate more, making it harder for the eyes to focus on the bright text. However, I wasn't able to find specific data that showed how strong that effect is. Personal bias can still play a role too. A lot of people are simply more used to black text on a white background, like on paper prints. Another interesting study compared different contrasts between text and background. It was shown that the more contrast, the better, in terms of eye strain. So basically black on white, or white on black. However, as for dark mode, the majority of people said that they prefer a slightly lesser contrast with a grey background. And if you look around, most websites and apps that offer dark modes do not use full-on white on black. I'm not exactly sure why that is the case though, I just know that I personally also prefer white on dark grey instead of white on black. Also, it has been shown that especially in dark environments, a dark mode is significantly less straining on the eyes than a light mode. You might also think that because dark mode is, well, darker, that it also consumes less energy. But that is only really the case with OLED screens. Most screens nowadays use a constant LED backlighting, which only can be reduced by reducing the overall brightness. And I want to throw in another study I stumbled upon, just because I find it kind of silly. They wanted to test if dark modes motivate people to a more immoral behavior. Imagine a shady hacker typing the codes into the dark console, stealing information and money. Well, it doesn't. I know, big surprise. I suppose sometimes you gotta do a study just to be absolutely sure. Oh well. Another big factor for digital screens is blue light. It is known that it suppresses your melatonin production, meaning that it messes with your sleep cycle. And it also has been shown that it can be the source of eye strain, more so than other colors. It can even cause damages to your retina. However, the amount of light emitted by smartphones, tablets, and computer displays is clearly below the amount of light our eyes would be subjected to during a sunny day. And people normally don't get blind by just going outside without sunglasses. Evolutionary, that would make no sense. Well, as long as you don't stare at the sun with your bare eyes. Please don't do that, even if it's during the middle of a solar eclipse. Important to note is that in terms of melatonin production, the color of the light plays a more important role than the intensity. Just simply reducing your screen's brightness won't help all that much in this regard. There are two methods for reducing the amount of blue light from the displays hitting your eyes. Well, three to be exact, if you count not using the devices altogether. It is advised to avoid looking at digital screens a couple of hours before bedtime. However, not everybody can or wants to follow that advice. Guilty. So one way would be to reduce the amount of blue light emitted by the screens directly. As I said before, just lowering the brightness isn't enough. There are so-called night shift or nightlight modes. Nowadays, many devices and operating systems offer something like that. Or you can download an app that does the same thing. So it basically changes the color settings of your screen, making it warmer. Most of the time, you can adjust the exact amount of color shift. However, even on very high settings, it is not able to change the color properties of the LED backlighting that most of our screens nowadays use. The backlighting still bleeds through the screen, and especially from the edges. And that white light also consists of blue light to a significant amount. So you additionally need to reduce the brightness of the backlighting. And then you end up with a very dim screen with even worse contrast because of the color shift. That is very hard to look at. Focusing on it, therefore, is quite straining. Also, studies have been mixed about the effects of night shift features. Some show that it does reduce the melatonin suppression levels, where others claim that it does not have a significant effect. It seems to me that more studies are needed. Regardless, you can just try it out yourself and choose the settings that feels the most comfortable to you. Another way to reduce the blue light would be by wearing glasses with blue light blockers. Those filter through all the light rays directed at your eyes, including those from the LED backlighting. Therefore, it is the most effective method, especially those with very strong filters. Studies have clearly shown the benefits of those glasses. They greatly reduce both eye strain and melatonin suppression. Maybe the yellow or orange tint of those glasses might need getting used to, but it's worth it. Alright, lastly, I would like to give you some of my personal experiences and tips. So, I'm in front of my PC almost all the time. However, I'm not struggling with eye strain all that much, and I think it is because I take some good precautions. First of all, I use dark mode whenever possible. If a website doesn't offer one, I use an extension that changes the colors for me. Highly recommended, even though it doesn't always work perfectly. I adjusted my text editor so that the background is dark and the text white. My screen's brightness is reduced to the bare minimum of what my eyes need, and I use a night mode to reduce blue light. Now here's the problem though. Windows' night mode applies to all screens equally, and all of my screens are different. Different models, different manufacturers. So I would get very uneven results. And the biggest problem is my drawing screen. Especially when I work on a colored project, I really need the full contrast and original colors. Reducing the brightness and/or shifting the colors, therefore, is a bad idea. You can quickly turn the night mode off and on, but that's a bit of a hassle, especially since I often need to look at both my drawing screen and my other screens. That is why I use a program that lets me adjust the settings for each individual display, including a slider for making the colors warmer. So all of my screens have a low brightness and reduced blue light, except for my drawing screen, which makes it a bit exhausting to look at for longer periods of time. I make sure that my drawing programs are in dark mode, but if I work on a bright looking project, then there is barely anything I can do. However, if I just need to do some sketching or line art, then I can change the background and tool color to make a dark mode for myself. Currently, I do not have blue light blocking glasses, although in the future I would like to get some. However, I wouldn't be able to wear them either if I work with colors. But at least I'm very consistent at taking breaks. The fact that I own a standing desk kind of forces me to take breaks. After standing in front of it for about half to 1 hour, my legs and back start to get tired, and I sit down on the couch behind me. I still look at my screens from there, but at least those are the color adjusted ones. And also I'm a bit further away from them. By the way, a standing desk is also a really good investment for your posture. I used to have neck pain, and my new desk completely resolved that issue. So, that's some advice that I can give. If you have some other tips, or there's a mistake to be pointed out, then please let us know in the comments down below. Again, I am not a medical professional. I just read a bunch of studies and articles and tried my best to summarize them. All of my sources are in the description, so feel free to check them out too. I really hope that this video was helpful to you. I wanted to make it because it is very relevant to me as a digital artist and video maker. My eyes are incredibly important to me, as are my hands. Speaking of, some years ago I also made a video about hand injuries and how to treat and prevent them. Also something very important for people who have to use their hands a lot. Alright then, thank you a lot for watching, and see you next time.